Thank you for joining us. A panel of inquiry set up to investigate the killing of 3 police officers and 2 civilians in Taraba State in August has found that both the police and military were responsible for the incident. The defense headquarters, in a statement on Tuesday, said the panel submitted its findings and linked the deadly confrontation to a breakdown in communication between the police team that went on an operation in Taraba State and the soldiers manning a checkpoint in the state. I'm being joined by a legal practitioner, Tunji Abdulhamid. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you for having me. It's my pleasure to be here.
It took almost over 2 months. Your thoughts on this investigative report?
Even though we have not seen the details of the report, we are only told that they were to face a penal reaction, which I believe is overdue, is normal. They don't expect anything less than that.
But why did it take so long?
They are compiling doing their investigation, maybe compiling their evidences or whatever. I wouldn't know. Yeah, I don't. When you want to take action against certain people, you don't rush into it, because if you rush into it and you don't have enough evidence to name them, even though they may be guilty, they may escape justice or punishment. So maybe they are taking their time to ensure that they have enough evidence within their hand before taking a proper action against.
But should it, in other crimes, this sort of investigation usually takes about 2 weeks at most, and then we get a report and then we see action being taken. But what we've just had, it's not even a full report made available to the public. What we have is a statement saying that 5 people have been found culpable in the incident and that they will be punished.
Yeah, they didn't say they will be punished now. They said they will face disciplinary sanction or action.
Yes.
So which means they will be subjected to other trial. Which means, like, for instance, maybe the military, you know, that's what they call a court martial. Maybe that's what they are saying. They have to go and face that court martial. That is where the penalty will not be meted to them. So I think, and in doing that, before you go into that, you have to do enough findings, arm yourself with necessary evidence for you to be able to do a tight case, or so that they won't be able to escape the justice in that regard. Because sometimes we talk about delay and whatever. I know cases are won in court and lost based on evidence before the court. If you have a case, if you say because you have a finding or on paper, or you had this and that, and you try to rely on that and go to court, you may fail. So you have to do proper investigation, do a tight case, and then they take the person to court. Maybe that was what they are doing. They are trying to look at it and see whether or not there's actually anything to take these people to court. So maybe they now realize that we have something on ground to take them to court. That's why the court they will take them to is a court martial. You know, they are military men, they will have to go to court martial and then they defend themselves there.
Now, we'll get back to all the issues that came up when that situation occurred. But let me ask you, 5 people, one of them, as at the time this story broke, the Wadumi came out to say indict one of the army officers, and he has been named. I think he's Tunji, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, 13 or so.
He is among the people that are to be sanctioned by the army. What do you make of, you know, a confirmation of the media report? Does that invariably mean that these 5 persons are the only ones that are culpable?
Now, they may be, they may not be. It depends on, like you said, we don't have the details of the report. We don't know what they have looked into. Maybe they've also examined other people and they realize that they are not part of it, or they didn't play any role in it, or they were not aware. We cannot ascertain that. We can only be permutating or making an assumption. So we have been told that only 5 people were found culpable to be able to face a disciplinary action. And let's take it like that, because they are the ones who did the investigation. We didn't do it.
Okay, but in your position, for lives were lost in this instance, and these were officers that were on national assignment trying to keep this country safe, what would be a fair punishment in the eyes, you're a lawman, in the eyes of the law?
I think they should be facing my murder case. At least it will be manslaughter. Manslaughter will be like life imprisonment. Murder is a death sentence.
Do you see this being like a whistleblowing, not so much a whistleblowing, but a way to deal with the corruption that seemed to pervade in the security setup? Because if there was no corruption, how would a kidnapped kingpin have in his arsenal of, you know, stuff to use to brag, an army captain who he communicates with on a regular?
Definitely there's corruption in the country. There's people are looking for money on all angles, and most people collaborate with the criminals. The criminals are making waves in this country, not because they have the that's intelligent above our military, but because one, they have enough, they have a sophisticated weapon compared to our military. Two, members of the same people are fighting them. Some of them are sabotaging the effort. Some of them are going behind to take them because they also have something to take. So the issue of corruption, that is clearly, is undisputable. We have corruption in this country. And then I think it's not only in the military, it's everywhere. Corruption is part of our system in the country now. Yeah. We hate corruption. We eat corruption. We sleep with corruption every day.
And we are working to eradicate it.
In fact, if you are in a position today and you are not corrupt, you are not making money, people will see you as somebody who is stupid. So you know you have to.
This is a very sad narrative. Actually.
It is. But that is reality. That is the reality. Because I remember when I was in secondary school or so, somebody was a speaker in my area. And he was trying to behave like somebody who wants to help society. Whenever he comes to, he lived, in fact, all throughout his tenure, he stayed at his family house. Which family house are we talking about? One room self-contained. One, face me and face you. It was when he became speaker that he said, when he said, now move to GR, he said, no, I'm not moving. This is where I will stay. Come and renovate my place. They converted it to room and parlor. Room and parlor self-contained. Because they don't have toilet in there. What I'm saying is that whenever this guy come back from the office, he will drop the official car, carry his own personal car, and he has just one. That time we have this telephone that, you know, when everybody wants to use it, even his children, he will say, no, this government telephone, he won't use it. He was doing that because of people. He wants to serve people. He doesn't want to use government money for his personal money. My people call him name.
Okay, hold on to your thoughts. Let's go on a short break. We have a guest joining us. Stay with us. We'll be right back. This is Plus Politics.